A very good morning once again. Thank you for joining us here on The Big Issue. You're in time for the rush hour that goes all the way till 10 a.m. But now we are talking interesting developments. Why the Makere convocation? You know, if you remember, we went into the new year after the elections at the Makere convocation. There was some sort of chaos, actually made headlines for some few days. That was 30th Friday, December of 2022. And we saw that a lot went on, still going on, and we still want to know more about the Makere convocation and how it is set to serve its people, why there were issues at during the elections, and of course, way forward. How do we move forward with all those issues? Why Makere, first of all? Makere has all sorts of issues, but why also the convocation? We thought, you know, things would have changed a little bit. But go to our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda, on Twitter, Urban Television, on Facebook, and be part of this conversation this morning. Today, my guests are George Mugabi Tunyamereba. He is the new convocation chairperson, elect, yeah, if I could put that way. We also have former candidate of the race, in the race, that was Charles Odongotho. Gentlemen, good morning and welcome to the show.
Good morning. It's a pleasure.
All right. I want to get into it, but maybe briefly if I could remind our viewers. This convocation is comprised of university alumni, non-teaching staff, and they held elections just recently, where it was characterized by violence, arrests, and allegations of rigging. Some seven candidates pulled out of this race. Others have gone to court, and I have, I think, one of them here who's gone to court to challenge the election. But we also have the winner of that particular election. And we want to get straight into it. And I just want to begin with you, George. The elections were actually thought to be marred by irregularities. There were allegations of malpractice. There were also chaos. We saw chaos. We saw a lot going on in that election. First of its kind, the first time. And you were declared winner with all that that happened. Do you feel like the winner?
Oh, yes. I'm a winner.
Okay.
Yes. I don't know actually what you mean by violence and irregularities. According to me, the conveners of the General Assembly did their best up to a time when some of the candidates and their supporters decided to disrupt the election. As you may be aware, this was not only an event for elections. It was an annual General Assembly, which was duly advertised in papers as required by the law, the constitution of the convocation, and the agenda was therein stipulated, and one of the items on the agenda were elections. As you know, the election is not it is not an event, it is a process. All the processes were followed according to us, but as you know, there may be hiccups here and there, but that does not mean that the election was a sham. What actually made it look like it was a problem, it was because our colleagues who were in the race, from the onset, they did not actually want the election to take place.
Oh.
Yes. You had so many letters, petitions that were coming through from our candidates, some of the candidates, some of them actually did not even participate. It started around November. people are raging things. And the problem, I think, is like maybe there is a fight between some of the people within the university who may be having issues amongst themselves, and they were sponsoring some of the alumni to cause chaos. You had those many letters, you had Lutaro, who authored so many documents prior to the election. You had people like Gerard Karuhanga running to court to seek for an injunction. That in itself explains that you had our colleagues, the Odongoso and others, petitioning before. And to me, that showed that they did not prepare for the election. And when they saw we are advancing and people were behind us, they started all those sorts of things to disrupt the election. I can give you an example. Mm-hmm. Before the incident, inside the hall, in the morning, in my camp, I already had about 1,200 people. And where our other candidates were, there was no one. Mm-hmm. We had mobilized enough. Even when you took at our team, we were so organized to the extent that each one, we are 11 members, each one of us, to begin with, were requested to look for at least 20.
Are you suggesting that your other fellow contestants were not ready?
Yes, they were not ready, because I can give you an example.
For they me, did not organize anything.
I started organizing as early as January 2022. Most of the candidates came in December. And by December, we were already on the ground. Even if you came on the ground, staff were singing Team George. And some of our colleagues thought they were going to use their personalities because they have been in parliament, because they have been journalists and appearing in media. They thought we are so weak, but they did not know that some of us were actually on the ground for the last 18 years. I have been a staff in Makerere University for the last 18 years.
Okay, yeah? Very yeah. Huge allegations there. Charles, here, you are on the spot. First, you were not prepared. Allegedly, some of your fellow contestants, including yourself, you did not want the election to go on. Maybe, I don't know why, you didn't want the election to go on, according to George. And some of you really just jumped onto the elections very late. Is that true?
Thank you very much. Good morning. And Happy New Year to my good friend, George.
Happy New Year to
George has said a number of things, but yes, many of them lies and exaggerations. But I will not dwell so many on so many of the lies. The only truth he said was that one, he has been a staff of the university for 18 years, that he's on ground. That's probably the only truth that he has said. George is, they say the devil is in the detail. Mm-hmm. And George has picked out words very carefully. One, he says that according to him, and for me I like that, because you know, the many times in an environment where systems are not respected and rule of law is not respected, it's important to say that, and it's contextual, that according to me, because he talked about the process, and I like that reference, that an election is not just an event. An election is a process, indeed true. I want to ask George, and to be honest with us candidly, apart from the fact that he won an election, let him be honest, as a lawyer, him and I are trained lawyers. You know, we studied in the same university, Makerere University Law School. And so I don't see a reason why he should lie, the victory was given to him with about 452. Was it 452? I think it was 452. And the reason why I'm saying that, there is a detail in why I say that. We shall later delve into it. Now, from the word go, it must be known, and viewers must know, that George was the official candidate for the outgoing executive led by Tanga. That's a given. So there is a reason why George was brought by Dr. Tanga, who was the chairman and insisted on organizing the election himself. Two, that because of that is the reason why there was violence. I am shocked. Violence, chaos, mess that you asked George about is something George, everybody saw. You saw. That's why you made it news.
But also George dismissed it.
Yes, he dismisses it because he knows he's a beneficiary of a sham system, of a sham process. He knows he's a beneficiary of the chaos. He sat quietly without, you know, without blinking and admiring the chaos that were being created by the person who was funding him, who was sponsoring him, rather. That is Dr. Tanga, the outgoing chairperson. And George knows that. George knows that the reason why our outgoing chairperson of the convocation wanted him were for reasons of, you know, going around and trying to, the allegation is that he's trying to dodge audit. Because as you can see, I wish you could eventually call other university administrators. For example, the chairperson of the council, the vice chancellor. They have written to Dr. Tanga demanding for accountability of the mess, and they have written it. Can a chairperson of council, George, lie that there was chaos at that level? That lady, I know her. She's very sober, Lona Magana, very sober. The vice chairperson, the Right Honorable Kidega Dan, a former chairperson of Yala, very sober guy. Now, with their counsel, by the time they write to Dr. Tanga, outgoing chairperson of the convocation, to say we need an audit, we need accountability of the mess, we need accountability of your entire last 8 years that is outgoing, there is a reason why they are doing that. That is the top administration of the university.
Just
now,
no,
for George to deny that is dishonest. Is dishonest. And I think that he has to own up to that. Now, on the election process, George knows up to when we had the candidates meeting, he was there. By the way, George is a fine guy himself. The only problem he finds himself as a not innocent now, not innocent because he has partaken of it. He is a willing victim, a willing captive of the sham process. And that George must know as he accepts this victory. Now, George says finally that he mobilized and that we were not prepared. I will tell you, I knew about the convocation from 2013. When they were organizing an election for 2015. And I started studying about the convocation and knowing, and even trying to study about others. When I knew that the term of Tanga was ending in 2022, I and a team started preparing from May last year. And we kept mobilizing quietly. We had mobilized from even within George's camp himself. Because we know it is an electoral college vote. An electoral college vote is not where you go in public. You organize quietly. Mm-hmm. And George, by the way, he says he mobilized over 1,000. As a candidate who was alone in the race, we left him alone in the race. And then they mobilized some, you know, very quiet, one of the staff of the university, some guy we didn't even know, or some or team or someone, to stand against George to legitimize an illegitimate, otherwise illegitimate process. But he got he got 452, if I'm not mistaken. He can bear us witness, he's here. But he says they organized over 1,000. Where are the rest? That is the big question George should be worried about, just in case this election is redone. Two, they bust people from Tororo. And you know why Tororo? George knows. I was in the university up to about on the 29th, up to midnight. We were seeing what were going on. I was in at the university by 6 a.m. I was at the camp where they were, personally, in a car. And I was watching what was going on. People coming, and they started giving them the cheats to enter. Quietly, I was there. I saw it. I even saw him come and then ushered into a certain place. How they were giving out the even to them, to their team. And they were issuing it from a tinted, actually a drone. From a drone, they were issuing it from there to only their supporters who had been brought all the way from Tororo. Tanga comes from Tororo. And this is the same thing that was done in 2015.
Huge allegations.
Fact.
All right, George needs to.
George is here.
Thank you so much. Indeed, these are allegations. To begin with, the chaos. The person who was.
First, tell us, was there chaos in the election?
The person actually.
On that day, on the 30th.
The person who was actually affected by the chaos was Tim George. Right?
Mm-hmm. How?
You had journalists on ground. Tim George had at least 80% of supporters who turned up there, and it is on record. Right?
Who entered the room, the
now,
AGM
Charles,
room?
Charles, I gave you time to speak. You arranged so many things. Kindly give me time to respond to them.
Please go ahead.
Because I have seen you are using your position in the social media, in the media to.
George, you are here together. I'm not using any position.
No.
Same platform.
And you said it. You said it even when we had that consultative meeting. You are asking us, myself, I'm a journalist. I have appeared everywhere. I remember you. I know you remember that.
Mm-hmm.
You even stated that Karhanga is an MOP. Give us just a debate and we show them.
Proceed.
Mobilization is not about how loud
one is.
Mm-hmm. It is about reaching out to the people. I want to make
about bribing.
I want to make this one clear. Makerere University Convocation is an association of staff and the alumni. The alumni are actually across the country. Across the world. We did not have supporters from Kampala alone, from Tororo. We had supporters across the country.
People do not
even
know English.
If we talk of buses
people
came,
do not even know English,
you
see, university graduates.
Charis, I want you to address your mind, and you kept saying that, and that's actually what annoyed our people,
including the chairperson outgoing.
That is what annoyed our people, the alumni and staff. You kept saying you are bringing Shamba Boy. I want you to address yourself to the constitution of the convocation.
Okay, let's go to that.
Right?
Let's go to
They say the convocation is an association of staff and alumni, and for your own information. You should know that even in Makerere University, there are people who are recruited as staff who are Shamba boys.
Mm-hmm.
Are you aware of that?
Go on. I have
and
given
I heard you, I saw you. We have staff who work in the farm. Aren't they staff? Aren't they members of the convocation?
Mm-hmm.
You went to Kabanyoro yourself. Which language were you using when you went to campaign in Kabanyoro? Because that is where some of our staff are. We have staff in Chibare. We have staff in Budongo. We have staff in Abyea. Were you aware that we have all those campuses and some of them are actually looking after cattle and they are staff? So we are smart to know that there are even staff who may hardly speak English, right? and they are staff of Makerere University. Mm-hmm. And the constitution does
and
not
dis-
and they are part of the convocation.
Right.
Unless you yourself and your support and your team are amending the constitution to remove those type of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Secondly, you are talking, I am seeing you. I want to ask you, which you have the constitution, which article of the constitution that was not complied with? I want you to
the
cite one.
On
I want you to cite one.
Notice was complied with? Notice of 30 days for calling AGM?
Oh, yes.
Tell me.
Oh, yes.
From when?
Oh, yes.
When?
I don't remember the dates offhand, but they advertised the new vision.
Did you follow the exchanges between
We are not going to go into the nitty-gritties.
Okay,
that's part of the constitution you're talking about.
That's why I brought up that point of like, there may be, actually they are influencers. Some of them are on the side of Odongo. So I'm not going to mention names here.
Mm-hmm.
The journalists, you can actually come on the ground and find out the facts. Whereas you are arranging that I am supported by Tango Doi, who also has the right to support a candidate.
Not openly.
Yeah,
It's good you have accepted it. I'm not admitting.
I'm just actually.
Gentlemen, I'm going to take a break. We're going to take a break because it seems we are failing to listen to each other. Let's take a break.
And it is called by Charles.
When we return,
I listened attentively.
We are still looking at the Makerere convocation and the issues. And you clearly see that there's a lot of issues, really. And so we'll take a break when we return. So much more on that. Welcome back from that break. You're still watching The Big Issue here on Urban TV. My name is Lynn Komujisha, and as you can imagine, it is hot behind the scenes with the chairperson-elect of the convocation, of Makere convocation, and that is George Mugabe Tiriamuneva, as well as a former contestant for the same position, Charles Odongo-Thoo. We're trying to understand what happened at the convocation. Moving forward, how do we change these things? But these guys are still stuck in what happened, and they're failing to agree on actually what actually happened. So really, we're having a very interesting conversation. Go to our socials and be part of this. Now, before we took a break, George, you were trying to explain to us why everybody thought that you were the official candidate for the election, allegedly, because you were fronted and you were supported by the chairperson of the current chairperson, and that is Dr. Tango Rodoy.
First of all, I don't know why people keep saying, I think maybe they are saying it because Tang Collins, who is my very long time friend, was part of my team. Mm-hmm. And I did not know Tang Collins just a year ago or 2 years ago. I knew him as a young kid. We were playing football together. We are friends. So when I had this idea, I called him and he joined me. And that one should not be really a problem. Secondly, Tang Collins has rights. He has the rights to participate in an election. Mm. And the convocation constitution does not buy him in any way from joining Team George. Mm. And for your own information, Odongo-Thoo, you have heard him.
He's here.
You have heard him say that he was the people who are from Toro were coming to
When did I say that?
We're coming.
When did I say that?
We're coming.
Don't talk about things we talked on air.
Charles?
No, let him refer to things we talked on air. There are so many things we talk in confidence. If you refer to things we discussed off air, on air, I will bring out everything we talked.
Okay. That one, okay. I can.
So finish up, because we have other questions.
Refer to official, non-public issues
or
things that are in the Constitution.
You know, Charles, I think maybe I'm not that kind of person. Even throughout our campaigns, I'm not that kind of person.
Then why did you accept to come to debate on air? If you're not that type of person, you should have used... You should have sent Tanga or Tanga Collins to come and debate for you.
If we want to debate alone, then you can debate around.
No, I can't.
I think there are rules.
Okay. Yeah? But Charles,
I actually wanted us to discuss the issues that led to the elections, the issues of the elections together.
I think producer should come and take Charles out of the studio because at this point I don't understand.
George is failing to explain his own point.
Let him finish, Charles. Then you can explain your thing. Please.
There is a lot of mixing of issues. Mm. The chaos that was started by our opponent, Charles Karuhanga and the rest, did not only affect themselves, it actually badly affected my team. I was expecting to win by at least 2,000 voters. Mm-hmm. But when they caused the chaos, the elderly, those who are coming from far, most of them left.
Okay. We shall come to
want also to talk about the allegations of the chair council, the vice chair council. Charles, you stated that the chair council has written, we have a constitution. This constitution is actually very clear. It stipulates that the supreme organ of the constitution is actually the General Assembly. If you want to amend, change, it actually states that even accounts, the issues of accountability, should be a business of the General Assembly. Okay. We had a General Assembly that deferred looking into the accounts to some time ahead because of the chaos that was started by, because the chaos reduced time we had to look at all those matters.
Your supporters were the ones who moved an amendment that the accountability should be defined.
Just let me conclude.
Dude, you are lying.
I want to be clear on this, that even the chair council, even the vice chair, are all members of the constitution, of the convocation. There is a clear procedure of how members can complain, can bring the issues to the attention of the executive, and therefore the General Assembly, so that they can be resolved. It is not like everyone will come, every member will come. You are a member. If you started from a career, there is a procedure, and it is in the constitution.
All right, George.
How
we'll,
people
we'll
can
get back to that.
Submit their issues.
We'll get back to that, but I need us to, we have very many things we want to, because we cannot dwell on the post-mortem right now.
Yes,
we need to move forward. Charles, you have, and when you were here last, you said you are likely going to court. Have you gone to court? That is one. You have a few things to address in there from what George has said. Have you gone to court? And why is he continuously alleging that you and your team and that of the other contestants were a bit rowdy and you're the cause of the chaos? Why were you not civil in these elections?
Thank you, Lynn. I like debate, no doubt. And I don't know, it's actually laughable that George, while he uses effectively the convenience on his part that he has been part of Makerere University for 18 years and looks at that as a good advantage and benefit to his side, he doesn't want me to use the God-given right or benefit of me maybe being outspoken, maybe being attentive to issues, being detailed and all that. I don't know why. And I will not apologize for that. Now, I take offense though when George openly lies about things that everybody saw. He has refused to admit that there was chaos. That's number one. Dishonesty, intellectual dishonesty, not a good thing for any leader. The other thing that he keeps alleging, and that has been synonymous with his team, is the issue that I participated, and he picks that from the alleged funder, his funder, Dr. Tanga Odoi, who went on TV to lie openly that I was drunk. I have never in my life tasted alcohol. I've never. I don't drink. And someone to say I drank, the judges are trying to continue to parrot that. You know, now, the lies he continued to say, that he adds another lie, and I'm shocked George does that. I have known George to be a decent person until the election day. And I would defend George's innocence until the election day.
Thank you.
When he says that it was because of the chaos that the question of accountability was deferred, yet he knows the team that they bust. You know, they brought buses, and I know the hotel where they went to stay in, of people from Tororo. Now, those people came with one idea. It was one of his supporters who stood up and moved the motion. Immediately, the chairperson started. If there are changes, like it is done in any, you know, in a meeting, that do we adopt the agenda as proposed? A member from George's team stood up and moved the motion that let's defer accountability and audit presentation issues to another general meeting. It was not because of the chaos, joint. Tell the truth. Now, issues that we need to be discussing. One, George said that the election was fully in consonance with the Constitution. Not true. One of the things that George said, which I agreed with, is that an election is a process. Brilliant. Now, when an electoral commission or the election body, in this case, it was that time Tanga in charge, which is against the Constitution. The Constitution says, for purposes of an election, the academic registrar will be the returning officer. He is also the secretary of the convocation. In that regard, he was the one supposed to be in charge of the election.
He was not around that.
He was not in charge of that election. The roadmap. Tanga's own roadmap, George knows. When we met on the Friday
Friday before 23rd, I think. It was the 23rd. 2 days to Christmas. Tanga said the register will be ready by Monday. There was no register, and there were three registers, George knows, by the day we were. That week of election,
okay,
there were three registers. Which one did
we
use? Those were the issues that led to the violence. Because people who came with their receipts, just 1 minute, please. People who came with their receipts, a receipt showing that you have paid, subscribed member, and that you are supposed to be an eligible voter, found their names were missing on the final day. And they were in over 4,000, 5,000. What he's talking about, that people who access the AGM, I'm finishing. People who access the AGM.
Are they in your petition? Or are they in
No,
your,
we can't talk about the petition
court,
here.
But have you gone to court?
There are people who have gone to court.
Okay.
There are people who have, there are people, by the way, I think today or tomorrow, who are, I think, there is a process of passing a vote of no confidence because of these issues in the outgoing executive. There is a court process. I may or may not be part of it. I can't say for now because I'm looking at the evidences. If it fits my thinking and that we have a cogent case, I am going to court. We have three months
okay.
within which to file a case. George knows. And all these processes are going on. Why? Way forward, you asked for. Because we want to sanitize. We want to clean up the convocation. The convocation is now a sham. I can tell you, George does not know what he's going into right now. Because he came into this convocation, led, okay, the humble animal they talk about is a sheep, that you lead to a slaughterhouse. It doesn't know it's going to be slaughtered, but it accepts to go. George is the sheep in the convocation. He has been led there innocently. He doesn't know. He has gone in for a slaughter.
Point of information.
And I can tell you.
Information.
By the way, being a sheep
not
is not an insult. Being a sheep is not an insult.
I want to give information.
It is actually
yes,
a compliment,
you,
George. Just a minute.
He talks a lot. I will forget some of that. I want to give information on that.
Let him give me information.
Eh? Okay.
For your own information, I want to let you know that I have been part of the convocation processes since 2006. When Bruce Baraba Kabasa was being voted chair convocation, I was his mobilizer. In his second term, I was a member on his executive.
And
right?
Then he didn't support you finally.
2015,
why?
In 2015, I was a contestant for treasurer in the convocation. I lost and I did not make any chaos.
Actually, you
I just
would,
went.
You would serve very well
I
as a
went
treasurer.
On the drawing board. You see, Charles, there is growth. I went for treasurer in 2015. Now I think I had enough experience to become a chairman.
Mm-hmm.
So you should not misinform the public
so can
that I'm very
now?
New. In
can
the convocation,
and
I don't know, and I don't know much about the convocation. You can proceed, sir.
Thank you very much for that long information. Now, George, what I know, way forward for the convocation, when we came into this election, one of our strong points was that what one of the biggest problems Makerere suffers is bad image and bad reputation, which has made people run away from it. You remember what engineer
Wana
ATM brought up and stated during the AGM. That was our strong point. That where Makerere University is now, 100 years, it doesn't need to be there. There is a bad, terrible reputation of Makerere University. Every small university that has come up, including the small, okay, sorry to use that word, smaller in number, public universities, and
Chance
now in terms of image doing better than Makerere University. And our issue was that we need to repair the damage that has been done, the dent that has been done to the image of the university in order to bring back alumni, over 500,000 of them across the world, that they can support the university and ensure they build it. Now, that is what you are heading into without knowing. For you, you are looking at it only from a finance treasurer perspective. We were looking at the bigger picture and
Charles,
the people who have backed
the manifesto.
Okay, right, Charles.
We did not speak to you.
All right, Charles.
We did not speak to you.
And Charles, I need you to keep quiet and, and let's hear from George. Now, George, with all these allegations and everything, first of all, this election looks bad on you, even from us, the public.
It is illegitimate.
It looks bad on you. You're going into the leadership that you have inherited a lot of bad things. So moving forward, what do you think needs to be done to make it everything better? What are you working on to make things better?
To begin with, allow me just one about 5 seconds.
Because we have like 2 minutes to finish.
About 5 seconds to respond to Charles. Charles alleges so many things, but he doesn't quote. I asked him in particular to quote any article of the Constitution that was violated.
I told you about the AGM.
The AGM.
We're not going back, George.
The period of notice.
Gentlemen, we are not going
Charles,
back.
Because Charles keeps interrupting, I want to make it clear that the role of the returning officer, who is the academic registrar, is on elections is to preside over the elections. But when the elections have been part and parcel of the annual general assembly, the chair of the convocation convenes the meeting and presides over the meeting. And when that part of the election comes, that's when they hand over to the academic. That is exactly what was done. I don't see.
Moving forward, George.
Moving forward. To begin with, some of the issues rotate about the nominal role, right? We have actually started, as we speak right now, we have started with the information that is available, that was availed during this process to make the database.
You started as who?
Right?
That is an important question. He hasn't taken over office yet.
No.
You started
you
as
see,
who?
Have
you been sworn in?
I am elected.
Have you been sworn in?
I'm elected.
Tanga's term is ending on 4th of April.
Lynn,
you should have asked him that.
Why doesn't he wait and he responds?
And
you're
lying. Out of time, gentlemen. As you can see, we're
and
out
I think
of time.
It is intentional for Charles to come here and keep shutting me down. And when
it's
he's
not
talking,
intentional
no, it is intentional. I think that's and when.
But
I,
if you
I
can
had,
fail to address two people,
last time,
how are you going to address 500,000 people? The
in,
alumni,
you
the
are,
alumni,
you are
and
saying
others.
That maybe I was dumb. I could not speak.
All right. I think
and
we,
it is intentional for you to keep shutting me down.
We have come to an end of this conversation.
And that should not be
and
really the chance
have a lot
I know.
To address. So. But you are still making a point. As you move forward, really, I'm very interested. In 1 minute, what are you going to do different?
First of all, we are going to have a database of all our members.
Will that address the issues? That
right. When you have the database, it will address the issues of like those who are on the roll and those who are not on the roll.
Okay.
Secondly, Charles said that he was coming to occupy the toilet.
Oh no!
it is, you know, it is on record. He tweeted. He posted.
I said toilet like.
We are
George, you
going,
know English. You are a lawyer.
We are
toilet like.
Right,
toilet like.
Put up. We are
you, what you do, George? One thing for me, check if you are still there.
We'll
digitize. Digitize, let the process be across the world.
Thank you very much for watching.
You just take my.